the children's librarian at the Scoville Memorial Library. Thank you for joining us on CATV6 for our children's story time. Today I'm going to read a couple of different stories. The first one I'm going to read is called Fancy Nancy and the Late, Late, Late Night. I adore visiting my neighbor, Mrs. Devine. Here we are having tea on her veranda. That's a fancy word for porch. When she was a child, Mrs. Devine lived in Hollywood. She used to see lots of movie stars. Only Mrs. Devine calls them celebrities. Isn't that fancy? She has a special scrapbook of photographs. Some are autographed. That means the celebrities signed them. Your scrapbook is extremely fascinating, I say. Fascinating is even more interesting than interesting. Ooh la la! Mrs. Devine says I can borrow her scrapbook if I bring it back tomorrow. Merci, 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 I say. At home, I pretend that I'm a Hollywood celebrity. I dress up in my most glamorous attire. That's fancy for clothes. I give my autograph to all my fans. I pose for photographs. I am late for a glamorous Hollywood party, I tell my fans. Au revoir. You say it like this, au revoir. That's French for goodbye. On my door, I put up a sign that says, do not disturb, because celebrities need their privacy. I want to look through Mrs. Devine's scrapbook, but I hear my dad calling us all in to dinner. After dinner, I learn all my spelling words. I am practically an expert at spelling. Before I know it, Mom says, Nancy, time for bed. Oh no! I haven't had a second to look at the scrapbook. I beg my mom to let me stay up later, but my mom says no. It's a school night. Tomorrow is Friday. Tomorrow you can stay up later. I put on my nightie and get in bed. My parents kiss me goodnight. Sleep tight, they say. But guess what? I am not going to sleep. Under the covers, I have concealed, that's a fancy word for hidden, a flashlight and the scrapbook. I stay up very late. It's almost 10 o'clock when I put away the scrapbook and I turn off my flashlight. I bet even celebrities don't stay up this late. The next morning, when my dad wakes me up, I'm exhausted. Exhausted is even worse than tired. At recess, I'm too exhausted to jump rope with Bree and my friends. I miss three of the words on the spelling list. My brain is exhausted too. After school, I return Mrs. Devine's scrapbook. She asks if I would like to stay for dinner and watch a movie called National Velvet. It's on TV tonight, and it's about a girl on a horse. I loved it when I was your age, she says. It sounds fascinating, but I can hardly keep my eyes open. I go home and start weeping, which is a fancy word for crying. When my dad asks what's wrong, I confess. I was naughty. I stayed up late, late last night, and I had a terrible and exhausting day. My dad doesn't scold me. He says, now you understand why you need a good night's sleep. That night, I go to bed even earlier than my sister. On Saturday, I wake up feeling glorious again. Glorious is a fancy word for wonderful. And guess what? Mrs. Devine taped the movie for me. I can see it tonight. Dad was right. Even fancy girls need their beauty rest. All right. The next book I'm going to read is called Hush, Little Ones. These are all the different animals. They go to sleep at night. Hush, little ones, you sleepy heads, warm and safe in your own special beds. Well, they have a nest because they're birds. Hush, little rabbits, don't make a sound. Sleep tight in your burrow, deep underground. Hush, little monkey, rest your head as mother climbs up to your treetop bed. Hush, little mice, it's time to rest, snug in the hollow of your cozy nest. Hush, little lions, no time for play, cuddle up close at the end of the day. Hush, little penguin, go to sleep, nestled between your father's feet. Hush, little kangaroo, close your eyes, drift into dreams as the moon starts to rise. Hush, little bear cubs, bedtime is here, warm in your den, where mother is near. Hush, little zebra, you'll be dozing soon by the light of the stars and the silvery moon. Hush, little ducklings, curl up tight, snuggle together all through the night. Hush, little whale, in the deep blue sea, it's lullaby time for you and me. Hush, little ones, in the pale moonlight, it's dream time now. Good night, sleep tight. All right, my last story today is a classic. Many of you probably are familiar with, it's Goodnight Moon. This was one of my favorite stories when I was a little kid. My parents would read this to me before I went to bed. In the great green room, there was a telephone and a red balloon and a picture of a cow jumping over the moon. And there were three little bears sitting on chairs. And two little kittens, and a pair of mittens, and a little toy house, and a young mouse. There he is. And a comb, and a brush, and a bowl full of mush, and a quiet old lady who was whispering, "Hush." Good night, room. Good night, moon. Good night, cow jumping over the moon. Good night, light and the red balloon. Good night, bears. Good night, chairs. Good night, kittens. Good night, mittens. Good night, clocks. Good night, socks. Good night, little house. And good night, mouse. Good night, comb. Good night, brush. Good night, nobody. Good night, Mush. And good night to the old lady whispering, hush. Good night, stars. Good night, air. Good night, noises everywhere. All right. I'd like to take this opportunity to tell you a little bit about our summer reading program at the Scoville Memorial Library. We're going to be doing a program called Dream Big Read, and it's going to begin, our kickoff is June 16th. We're going to invite the Sharon Audubon to come to the library and do a program with us beginning at 11 o'clock. They're bringing birds of prey, so they'll be bringing three owls and a hawk to the library. We'll follow that up with a ice cream social, and the friends of the library are going to be selling some books. So the summer reading program is sponsored by the friends of the library, so if you'd like to stop in for that, sign up for the program and find out more about it, you can do that on Saturday, June 16th. You can also learn more about the program on our website or by calling the library. My name is Erin Simmons. You can reach me through email. It's esimmons, S-I-M-M-O-N-S, at biblio.org. You can also call the library at 860-435-2838. You can visit our website at scovillelibrary.org. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you at the library or next time here on CATV6.